Okay, take three. We're on the air. My name is Stephen Yates. I'm a member of Art by the Sea, the artist cooperative of Bandon. I've been a member for 3 years now, I believe. Been lucky enough. The group voted me in, and I mainly do woodwork. And I probably started doing woodwork when I was about 11 years old. My cousin came up from San Francisco, and he came up for the World's Fair in 1962, and he was telling me about kids that were taking old skates and building what they called skateboards. So I had to try to build a skateboard. So we went to the Goodwill and found an old pair of metal skates and tore them apart, and I built my first skateboard with him. Now, there's a really good thing that you have to do with a skateboard, and it's called alignment. Because the first time I tried out the skateboard, I went right into the rocks. So that was my first experience, really, with working with wood. And from then on, it just has blossomed. And I think probably some of the most enjoyable work I've done has been in the movie work. But I enjoy a lot of the woodworking, and I've worked with wood all my life. Question? I'm gonna answer any questions.
So when did you start making tables and bowls that we know you for?
I think it was about 5 or 6 years ago. I'd made tables before, kind of beach tables. But I got an idea that I wanted to work with resin with some of the woods and inlay some of the tables. And so I've done that with a few tables. But I like myrtle wood so much because of the beautiful coloring it had, and maple also. So I started building those mainly about 3 or 4 years ago. And those have been very, very popular for me, and they're pretty satisfying to build too. So
how do you make these tables? Like, do you mill the lumber yourself, or how do you get it?
Well, I get the lumber's rough cut, and I'll take them to a fella that's got a planer, unless they're too wide. And he'll plane them for me, and then I'll do a lot of the sanding on them, and I'll sand them, quite a bit. It's mainly a lot of the sanding. But what I liked about the myrtle woods and the maples also was you could get them smooth enough that they're almost like glass. And so I like. And I designed the legs for the tables because I wanted the wood to be the accent piece. And a lot of the time I felt that the wood legs took away from the actual tabletop. So I started doing the metal legs, designing those, and then having Ron up at Bandon Fabrication build them for me. And they've been pretty popular. So it's been pretty gratifying.
Do you put oil? Do you kind of seal it with oil, or?
Usually there's a Danish oil or oil and wax on the tables to seal up the grain. And mainly it's a Danish oil that I've used. The bowls, I like to use a food grade oil for those, and the cutting boards that I'll do, I like a food grade oil to be able to use for platters or a cutting board or something of that nature.
So when you have clients that buy your tables, do you suggest that they oil it again, or is it like set for life?
Well, depending on the climate they're in, where they go, where they live, I'll suggest what I think would be best for them. If it's sealed up, they don't usually need to do much in a drier climate for 3 or 4 months. Probably with, you know, an oil and wax mix or something like that, wax the table, you know, about once every 3 or 4 months. In a wetter climate, you probably want to take a little bit more care of it. But what else?
So what would you suggest, like if somebody spills water on it, like will it stain?
You just want to wipe it off fairly quick. Yeah, it shouldn't have too much effect on it.
Okay, and then for your bowls, how do you go acquiring the wood?
Well, I have a couple of people that I like to buy the wood from. I like especially the maple burls or the myrtlewood burl. I like to work with those because they're kind of unusual to me. You don't see a whole lot of those. And so those are a lot of fun to do.
Yeah, and I know you came to our place after it burned looking for some nice big pieces, but they weren't. Well, there is one big maple, but it's pretty hard to get to.
Yeah.
You know, but
it's hard to find the burls.
Yeah.
Usually a lot of the loggers will bring them to this fella I buy from. And then he'll have them sit for up to a year drying out, or I'll take them home and dry them for quite a while also before I start working with them. So.
Okay, well, thank you, Steve.
Thanks, Muriel.
Thank you, Steve.
You bet.